coast and floorboards to shingles. This is the Money Pit Home Improvement Radio Show. I'm Tom Kraeutler.
And I'm Leslie Segrete.
And we are here to help you with your home improvement projects. Let us help solve your do-it-yourself dilemmas. Pick up the phone and help yourself first by calling us at 1-888-MONEYPIT, 888-666-3974. Coming up on today's show, bright floral colors might be a great look for a summer evening, but it turns out that those are the very same colors mosquitoes are most attracted to. We're going to have tips on how to dress to avoid those bites.
And are your kitchen cabinets a clutter of pots and pans that just fall out everywhere when you open the doors? Well, adding a few simple space savers can help, and we'll share some tips.
And when you hear the name Speed Queen, does it remind you of the big, strong industrial washers and dryers that you'd see in laundromats or college dorms? I mean, that's what it means to me. I remember my mom taking me to those laundromats and seeing those big Speed Queen machines. And now it turns out that those same industrial-tested machines are available for your home. Mike Shabe is the guy that makes that happen. He's going to be joining us from Ripon, Wisconsin, to talk about some of the rigorous testing they do to make sure every machine can deliver 25 years of service. The number is 1-888-MONEYPIT, 888-666-3974. Let's get to it. Leslie, who's first?
Bob in Texas is on the line with an air conditioning question. What is going on at your money pit?
What I've got is some rust and calcium in my primary condensate reservoir, and the HVAC service guys tell me that I probably need to replace the evaporator coil because he can't seem to, you know, get it to unclog and where the primary condensate drain, you know, drains properly. And he says there's no pan that they make for it.
How old's the condenser?
He said it looked like it was put in when the house was built, which would be about 40 years ago.
Yeah. I mean, the fact that it's 40 years old, it probably would make sense to replace it. Just keep in mind that if you want to improve the efficiency, which I'm sure you will, you have to replace the air handler, the evaporator coil, and the condenser at the same time because they're kind of a matched system. If you don't care about that, you could just replace the condenser. But I think at 40 years old, yeah, it's basically run the course of a normal useful life, and it probably would make sense for you to replace it.
Okay. Well, then I feel like I've gotten good advice, so thank y'all very much.
You're very welcome. Good luck with that project.
Ella in Arkansas is on the line with a roofing question. How can we help you?
I got a roof job coming on this in a couple of weeks. They're doing my roof, and they're doing my siding. Now, I had a big oak tree in my backyard. I had it cut down. But in the meantime, since it was there so many years, it left mold, you know, the green stuff growing on my shingles, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
The guys that's going to do my roof said that, oh, that's okay. You can get up to 3 layers of shingles before you have to take the old shingles off. And I say, well, mold strikes a negative vibe in me because my husband and I have allergies. Would that affect us? They say they're going to put the new roof over the old roof and the mold. I told him, no, that's not going to happen. He said, well, what we'll do, we'll spray it with bleach, the mold, and we'll rake it, and then we'll just cover it with the new roofing. And my question is, since it is so much money, is that wise?
Well, here's the thing. Yeah, I mean, you can put 3 layers of shingles on, but it's a really bad idea to do that, aside from the fact that you've got some sort of growth on this roof. Whenever you put a second layer of shingles on, the first 2 layers, in your case, tend to retain a lot of heat. And especially in an environment like Arkansas, where you have really hot summers, as that heat is retained, it accelerates the deterioration of the top layer. So in my experience, if you had a roof that typically would last 20 years, you put a layer or two of shingles underneath, you're going to have it last more like 13 to 15 years. I've seen it cut a quarter to a third of the life off by doing that. So it's always smart to remove old layers. They're probably trying to avoid it because it's expensive to remove old layers. They got to pull it off and then got to get rid of it. But it absolutely is the best way to do a roof replacement. And if you're planning on being in that house.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.